Expanding the category of hate crimes to include the hanging or placing of a noose is under consideration now in Annapolis. Several noose hanging incidents prompted the bill. This form of racial intimidation is not against the law in Maryland, but two bills are under consideration at the State House. However, as News 11 reporter David Collins shows us, the proposals are a subject of a meeting.
It is a bill of good intentions, but as drafted, it may violate the First Amendment. And one prosecutor characterizes it as an overreaction.
The noose, a symbol of hate, meant to intimidate and instill fear. The noose is universally recognized as a way to terrorize African Americans. Someone hung a noose outside the predominantly African American Cultural Center on the campus of College Park last year. A black Baltimore City firefighter used a noose to generate sympathy for himself and as a racially charged distraction to a cheating scandal in the department. The Southern Poverty Center reports nearly 50 noose incidents across the country since the Gina 6 case in central Louisiana.
I think we need to send a message to the public, say, you know, Maryland, we cannot tolerate this.
Prince George's delegate Victor Ramirez is sponsoring legislation making hanging or placing a noose a hate crime.
We know what it means. We know what it means hate. We know what it means division. And, you know, it's respecting other people.
But as written, the bill may violate the First Amendment. The ACLU raised the issue during a hearing on the measure.
But because the bill right now singles out one form of expression, as reprehensible as that expression is and as hateful and terroristic as it may be, that creates First Amendment problems.
The Judiciary Committee is expected to amend the language. A noose could be considered a weapon, but more importantly, a sentence-enhancing mechanism for crimes such as trespassing or defacing property. A conviction would carry 3 years in prison.
The Constitution supports enhanced penalties for hate crimes. If the bill served as a sentencing enhancement for criminal conduct based on discriminatory motive, it would be constitutional.
Harford County Prosecutor Joe Cassidy cautions against overreacting.
This to me is, you know, a huge reaction to one or two incidents. You know, and I think that we end up actually encouraging people to do this sort of behavior by the sort of blown out of proportion reaction to it.
The challenge, according to legal experts, is to deter and punish this type of threat and intimidation without sacrificing the First Amendment right of expression. In Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.